passage, as you described, many miles away. Can you give us a sense of what that was like for people?
Well, I tried to get close to the site of the explosion yesterday, and the highway leading from the north towards the capital was basically a blanket of shattered glass and rubble. Tractors were trying to clear the rubble so that the cars could go by, and the ambulances were trying to rush to the scene through very, very heavy traffic. So for all of these people around the site of the explosion, for quite a significant distance around the site of the explosion, it was really just a matter of luck where you happen to be at the moment the blast strikes. It's what's going to determine the kind of injury you're going to have, whether you're going to live or die, and what's going to happen to you. And that's talking about the wounded and the death toll. And of course, for all of those who are in the vicinity of the explosion, the question is how are they, even the lucky ones who weren't wounded, how are they going to rebuild their homes?
Hey there. Did you finish your puzzle?
Material like glass, wood, everything you think of when you think of basic reconstruction stuff, prices are going through the roof. So really, I mean, there's never a good time for such terror to strike any city, but for Beirut, you can hardly imagine a worse time than this.
Okay, let's see if you can put a picture together.
Stories from those who were caught up quite close to the explosions of vehicles being lifted off the ground and thrown some distance. And also, as you mentioned, the infrastructure to office buildings, to homes as well.
Yes, complete destruction inside homes and offices. Just everything.
Let's see how you do with these guys.
I haven't been able to go inside one of these yet, but that's a hearing from friends and from everybody who's good.
It was a catastrophic explosion. The blast was heard 150 miles away. Another view from moments earlier shows a fire in Beirut. Authorities say the flashes were caused by fireworks. But then,
Daddy, I'm done.
How'd you put everything together so fast?
I put the people together, then the map got fixed by itself.
We were at home. We heard what sounded like fireworks. We thought it was a container in the port
that was on fire. Wow. Wonderful job. Good job.
Already heavily stretched by the COVID crisis, Beirut's hospitals were overwhelmed by casualties and surgeons.